This minimalistic artwork I created in Blender, and minimalism is about achieving impact with fewer elements, embracing clean lines, open space, and restrained color palette to guide the viewer focus. It's often about using just enough details to convey an idea without overwhelming the sense. And today I want to share with you my process of creating creative artwork using Blender, and we also will talk about why minimalism is a good key to amazing artwork. In this artwork I started with a cube and subdivision modifier, though it seems like sphere would be more useful for that shape, but no. If I add a sphere just to compare with cube, you may see the top part of the sphere has triangulated faces, while the cube has quad uniform faces on each side of the mesh. So this topology is much better for modeling, especially sculpting, because I will get a correct topology with quad faces along the whole model. In the beginning my goal was to make a base shape of this rock, and I used standard Blender brushes like grub and clay strip. After that, I have to subdivide the mesh to get pretty dense mesh to further sculpt in details. And instead of simple subdivide mesh, I used a multi-resolution modifier, because this allows me not only to subdivide mesh, but also control subdivision level for sculpting, rendering, as well as viewport. And it's a better way to sculpting in Blender. After that I had pretty dense mesh, and I already used fill brush but with constant falloff. With these settings this brush makes such precise and slightly rough strokes, somewhat like rough shape of stones that I need. Finally I used rock texture to sculpt in details. You know, this could be ignored as I was going to use the displacement rock texture, but I wanted a rougher texture of stones that would have the texture of displacement matched with this rock, and I would get such a rough stone impression. In order to easily break the stones into small pieces, I used a self-fracture don with almost the default settings. By the way, if you can't find self-fracture in the Blender, go to Preferences, find self-fracture on and enable it. After that you can find self-fracture in the quick effects for the object. I just changed to random and noise level I set into 1. Press OK and the Blender will break the object into small pieces, so which I need. So to make such a flying stone effect, I will not even use simulation in the Blender. I just select one piece, for example this top one, and using proportional editing I can drag this piece and all the neighbor pieces will move proportionally to it. It's enough for me to use complex simulation, just to pull a few pieces of stone with my hands, and all the rest will beautifully form such a cool effect. Additionally, I've selected all these pieces and used randomized transform in Blender to get more chaos to all the pieces in the stone. I wanted it looks like a wobbly construction. As I said, simplicity. And I don't even have to do complex simulation to just get something like this. Actually, simplicity creates cool art. What could be more ordinary than just taking a light source and putting it inside these stones? And bunch of stones turn into interesting object, right? Write in the comments if you also understand this principle of simplicity. As I already mentioned, I want to use some rock texture with displacement, so I definitely need to enable displacement in the material settings, but not too much. Yeah, it still should look like a stone, not like a hedgehog. And essentially, to turn this one into stunning artwork, I need only one simple action – volume light. This is coolest thing that you can use and literally turn a simple picture of rock into beautiful story. I used my volume presets, but just adjust density and color. By default it's blue, so I guess it's much better to use a simple color because the main focus must be on this warm light from inside the stone's heart, and surroundings must not distract us from the main point. Also, I will change in the position of some stones till the end of the walk, because I tried to catch the interesting light shapes between these pieces. That's what I also want to say. If you're doing some marking in progress, you noted that it would be great to change something, but you start searching for some thoughts about why you do not necessarily make these changes, because you spend a lot of time, and of course it's hard to force yourself to do changes. If you see that it's possible to make your art better, do not seek excuses for yourself. It definitely will not lead you to masterpiece. Simplicity is the ultimate sophistication, but it also means cutting off everything unnecessary to achieve the desired result. I also use texture light from my blender sets. It's going to be some light beams, and I want this light to touch some stone pieces, just to emphasize some of them, like a lonely light ray. By the way, if you need to get the same blender sets, I will put the link to my shop and discount code for you, so check this out in the description. Also, I need another light just behind the stones. First of all, it separates these dark stones from the background, and secondly, it also creates these light parts between pieces, so it emphasizes that these parts of the massive stone also is broken into small pieces. This is a contrast light setup. The top part highlights from the viewer side, but the bottom part, vice versa, has light behind the object. And for the background, I thought it would be great to add some cloudy sky. Since I already have a lot of volume in the scene, these clouds create some noise effect to this volume. And yeah, again, simple things are the ultimate sophistication. And I need some ground below my artwork for the plot, and I was supposed to place here some stone spikes directed into the stone and broken heart. This ground is standard mountains, which I created using landscape add-on in Blender. Just using grub sculptor brush, I created this shape, and using the same way as for the main stone, I created this spike, which then I used to paint this spike on the ground. I use the secret paint add-on for the Blender. Literally, this add-on allows us paint by using 3D object in the 3D scene. And since it works as a hair system, it allows me to adjust the size, move and rotate each spike by using hairbrush in Blender, or making adjustments to a group of spikes, so it's pretty useful to work instead of some scatters in Blender. So, a little bit of particles which will fly off from the center of the light emitter stones, just to add in dynamic of scattering the scene. Also, I've decided to add some floating rocks to the background using the particle system in Blender and this collection of small stones that I've created before. So, the same rocks will be floating down behind the main stone, which also add a variety of dynamic to the scene. Here is only one secret. Since I already have two particle systems in the scene, when I start animation, everything starts at the same time, and when I'm delighted with the rocks, the first particles already scattered far away from the center. To make it more attractive, I just set the start frame to particles with rocks to -100. And yeah, do not forget to check pick random and object rotation in the instance collection. Now, when I start playing animation, rocks already floating, but these small particles just start flying, and I choose frame between 20 and 26, so it's a hero frame for my artwork. Yeah, it already looks cool, but one thing that I definitely want to add is a little bit of post-production. And in Blender we can make it write and read a report using a real-time compositor while we are working in an interactive render. Just enable compositing for the camera or viewport, and I'm going to use my glow presets for compositing to make amazing glow light and of course color gradient. Also, I wanted to get nice and sharp details, which is why I added a filter node in compositing with Diamond Sharp. It brings this crispy effect to the artwork. And I guess it would be nice to add some fog and dust, but instead to do this in compositing, I'm going to add a new plane into this scene and add here an overlay image of dust. Place this plane in front of the scene so it covers the bottom part of the frame. It also was possible to add this overlay in compositing, but using this way in a 3D scene, I will get this dust right with necessary color and light, like in the 3D scene, and don't need to adjust it in compositing. So, it looks already pretty nice. Just small color correction in compositing, and I would also want to emphasize this light. I mean this light ray from top light, and I need a mask. So it's pretty simple to draw in Blender, and in compositing using this mask is with another color balance node to adjust this light and add a little bit darker around this mask. So finally I add some adjustments to these pieces of stones because I wanted to see more attractive gaps and lights between rocks. Using proportional editing in Blender we can easily move them to necessary result. As you can see, this is absolutely simple scene, but what is a well looking result, and this is what I wanted to say with simplicity is the ultimate sophistication. Yeah, someone may say that the art must be complicated and your computer must be suffering while you're rendering this, but that's not totally right about art, because art is not about process, it's about what you get as a result. I'm a big fan of minimalistic artwork, and I guess it's more visually aesthetic. When the picture is not full of details, the viewer can interact with the details, immerse yourself into the plot, think, while the scene is full of details gives more stress to the brain and get what to think. Just as people can spend hours looking at abstract picture with simple form, diving deep into their thoughts and consideration. Do not think that the art must be complicated. Sometimes simplicity can say more. And I hope that I have been able to show you that creating art through understanding simplicity, not complicating it with unnecessary details, it's not only interesting, but also so simple. Subscribe to my channel and hit the like to this video if it was useful for you. Also, subscribe to my Patreon, you will not only support my channel and creating useful content about digital art, but you also can get access to exclusive tutorials and private Discord chat for answering your questions, as well as access to all materials from my video. Special thanks to my Patreon supporters, and see you in the next video, guys.